الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وبعد. We spoke before about the essential aspect of Tawheed, that is invocation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We heard lately, and this is not a new topic, this is a very old topic, but some people revived it today using the internet, that invoking others besides Allah is not shirk. And some of them came with the idea that if somebody is ignorant and invokes others besides Allah, such as a dead person, a tree, a stone, out of ignorance, then that's not shirk. It's bid'ah. We spoke before about this aspect that bid'ah is the foundation of kufr, shirk, and isyan. It's the foundation. Because every aspect of kufr and shirk and defiance of Allah begins as a bid'ah. So saying that it's a bid'ah, okay, what type of bid'ah? And we explained before with evidence from the Quran and Sunnah, statements of Salaf al-Salih, the biggest imams of Islam, that invoking others besides Allah is shirk. It is shirk. This is the type of bid'ah it is. It is shirk. And those who committed out of knowledge are mushrikun. Now, somebody threw in the, you know, side distraction, actually. What about the ignorant person who commits it? He's just committing bid'ah, he's not committing shirk. No. You have to understand that you have to separate between the issues. The act itself, shirk, always will be shirk, always was shirk, no change here. The people who commit it are under different, you know, categories. Some of them do it out of knowledge. They know what they're doing. Some of them, they know it's a bid'ah, they still commit it. Some of them, they're ignorant. Some people told them to do these things and they don't really know about why they're doing it and why they should be doing it or whatever, just, you know, ignorant people. This type of ignorant people is also of two categories. Like, for example, the person who's been telling them that if somebody commits this, you know, out of, because they're jahil, they're ignorant, whatever, then, you know, it's not shirk. That's not true. Because we're not talking about the act. We're talking about a person. A person is not an act. So the person himself now could find from a judge, a Muslim judge, and only a Muslim judge who has knowledge in the Sunnah, some excuse for, you know, them being ignorant because they didn't get the knowledge about this issue. Then they're taught the knowledge and then they're told not to do it again. So these people have now earned knowledge. They can't keep using the excuse of being ignorant. And the people that listen to this person specifically who's been talking about this issue lately, well, he told you about it, so it's not ignorance in your case either. See, so somebody to come and say, well, I'm doing it because I'm ignorant. Well, that man told you that it's shirk, but, you know, in case of ignorance, so you now know. You're not ignorant anymore. These issues are, you know, an essential part of Tawheed in comparison, contradiction to shirk. How is it that after all these centuries, so many Muslims don't know about these aspects? This is amazing by itself. But today we're going to make an important suggestion, a three-step verification that, you know, invoking is ibadah, is tawheed, and the type of tawheed is tawheed al-uluhiyyah. Now, let's talk about tawheed al-uluhiyyah. The biggest shahada in existence, the biggest statement of all time is La ilaha illallah. This statement has two inseparable parts. They come together. The first one is called nafi, negation. The second part is called ithbat, affirmation. And here is the statement. The nafi is in La ilaha. There is no ilah. Here, there is the complete denial that there is any ilah, any God to be worshipped, any person to be worshipped, anyone who deserves to be worshipped. So we negate from everyone and everything here and affirm it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So la ilaha illallah. You see the statement here? And it starts with the negation, because first the heart should be cleansed and the mind should be cleansed of everything and everyone that one seeks for any kind of worship, any type of worship, any type of invocation, need to be cleansed. Take them out and you replace them, bring inside your heart only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you're saying la ilaha illallah. So ilah is the worshipped one. Tawheed al-uluhiyya is about affirming that Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped and the only one. So this is tawheed al-uluhiyya. This is la ilaha illallah. Now, I spoke about a three-step verification, and I wish that the brothers and sisters, inshallah, they memorize these. It's not a short, sentence each, and it's not a long lecture. I'm just going to read these three, you know, points, and bi-idhnillah, you will understand, you'll verify yourself that they're easy to understand, easy to remember. Isn't it, you know, the Quran itself, it's easy to understand, easy to remember. Also the Sunnah, it's easy to understand, easy to remember, because the Sunnah is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, we bring one hadith, two ayat, three steps. Step number one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ad-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah." I'm trying not to have the reflection from the lights and the glasses. So the hadith is, "Ad-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah." قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الدعاء هو العبادة. Step number one, دعاء is العبادة, the worship. Clear? So Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is teaching us here. He's saying الدعاء, invocation, هو, it is العبادة, worship. And Allah created us to worship Him. How? الدعاء هو العبادة. Originally in Arabic, صلاة means دعاء, to invoke. Of course, when Islam came, our Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم taught us the full, you know, description of the صلاة. It's not anymore a mere دعاء you make to Allah. It is called صلاة too. So دعاء involves all aspects of worship. What can I say? I mean, the hadith says الدعاء هو العبادة. Then الدعاء هو العبادة. Imam Ahmad, Imam Abu Dawood, Imam al-Tirmidhi, Imam Ibn Majah, Imam al-Hakim, among others, collected this hadith, which Imam al-Hakim, Imam al-Dhahabi, and Imam al-Albani graded as sahih. So we have major scholars of hadith collecting this hadith, major scholars of hadith saying this hadith is authentic, sahih. So dua is al-ibadah. What about ibadah? Here, look at this hadith now. We're going to talk about what comes after the hadith. So al-dua huwa al-ibadah. Look at this hadith, please. Three words. Al-dua huwa al-ibadah. So all and every aspect of dua is ibadah. All of them together are al-ibadah. Now, look at this ayah. It's in Surah An-Nisa. It's in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 36. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Step number two. وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. الدعاء هو العبادة. What about عبادة? Worship Allah, meaning alone. وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Do not commit any shirk with him in anything or anyone. See? الدعاء هو العبادة. العبادة cannot coexist with shirk. See? الدعاء هو العبادة. العبادة is worshiping Allah alone. وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Now, the ayah here, worship Allah, do not commit shirk in him or with him with regards to anything or anyone. Because he is, you know, alone. Allah, tawheed, la ilaha illallah. So you only worship Allah and do not commit shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any way or form. Now look at this ayah. وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Three words, الدُّعَاء وَالْعِبَادَةِ. We have six words here. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ, He mentioned its opposite, that when somebody worships others besides Allah, he'll be committing shirk. So وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ alone. Otherwise, if you worship others besides Allah, you are committing shirk. وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. So it means here, وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ, worship Allah alone, in sincerity, alone, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Do not commit shirk, because ibadah cannot be directed, cannot be given to anything or anyone except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one. And those who deviate from ibadatullah to bring in others in the worship, they're committing shirk. The ayah here is clear. وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. So the opposite of ibadatullah alone is shirk. And therefore, someone who worships Allah and worships others besides Allah, they're committing shirk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you can't do that, because shirk devastates tawheed. Shirk devastates tawheed. And we said before, la ilaha, take everything, every allegiance to any person in what only Allah deserves, such as and including the acts of worship. I take everybody out of the heart, cleanse it from all this, and bring in la ilaha illallah. Because in our religion, worship is the invocation. Worship can only be done in sincerity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no shirk. And look at this ayah now, which is the proof that this type of invocation has to do with tawheed al-uluhiyyah. Now, the person who today is coming up with these things that, you know, invoking others besides Allah, that person is not shirk. It ain't tawheed. I can guarantee you that it isn't tawheed. So it is shirk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, which is Surah Al-Qasas, Surah 28, ayah 88. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instructing everyone. Instructing his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to instruct us, to tell us. And we have it. وَلَا تَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَهُ لَهُ الْحُكْمُ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Magnificent ayah. الدعاء هو العبادة. وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is connecting the dua with tawheed. See? In contradiction to shirk. See? الدعاء هو العبادة. وعبد الله ولا تشرك به شيئا ولا تدع مع الله إلها آخر. First of all, إله has to do with إلوهية, that Allah is the worshipped one, the only one who deserves to be worshipped, because this is entailed in the meaning لا إله إلا الله. The ayah is clear. ولا تدع مع الله إلها آخر. Do not invoke besides Allah another ilah. La ilaha illa huwa. There is no ilah except him. Kullu shay'in halikun illa wajhahu. Everything dies except Allah's face. Lahu al-hukmu. The decision is his. Wa ilayhi turja'un. And you are going to go back to him. Wallah, this is a magnificent ayah. The lessons in here are tremendous. First of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here clearly says that dua is for Allah. Otherwise, you'll be calling others besides Allah. See, tawheed, uluhiyya. وَلَا تَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخر. وَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرٍ. So Allah here says, dua can't be directed at others besides Allah. Otherwise, it will be an ilah. Such as one invoking a dead person, a tree, a stone. And they're invoking these objects because they want something. See? But these things cannot give anybody what they want, especially the dead person. He can't help. If he could help, he would have stayed in this life. They would have wanted to stay in this life a little more. If they're righteous, worship Allah more. If not, to escape from Allah's punishment, thinking they can repent of whatever. So calling a dead person is one of the most illogical aspects of what people have been doing for centuries and centuries, subhanAllah. And they say, La ilaha illallah. They hear the adhan, La ilaha illallah. They go to the salah, La ilaha illallah. They finish the salah, La ilaha illallah. They go to a dead person, tell him, we need things. So Allah here, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is connecting things. Dua. They say dua, you know, somebody calls others besides Allah. It's not shirk, it's a bid'ah, if it's ignorance, whatever. But Allah, he said that dua itself could decide one's tawheed or shirk. وَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخر. The fact that somebody is invoking others besides Allah is by itself shirk. It's taking another ilah besides Allah. And Allah here says, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ. The negation, see? Don't call others besides Allah, because you will be calling an aliha or an ilah besides Allah, because la ilaha illallah. The negation and the affirmation, nafi wa ithbat. Another aspect of this ayah, Allah says, kullu shay'in halikun illa wajhahu. Several meanings to understand from this part here. كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَهُ. It means that who are you calling? You should be calling the one who never dies. He's always there for you. Day, night. Somebody might be in the midst of thousands of people. And everybody is doing their own business, whatever it is, and somebody is saying in his heart, oh Allah, forgive me. And Allah hears him or her, because he's the one who hears and he's the one who's always there. Other people that are being invoked, they're dead. They are going to be destroyed before the day of judgment or on the day of judgment. they will all be destroyed. The sun, the moon, the stars, the trees, stones, everything will be thrown into the fire. The sun will be thrown into the fire. The moon will be thrown into the fire. It will be done. Because everything dies and perishes except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything dies except the wajh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he says, lahu al-hukmu, the decision about these aspects is not for you. It's for him. The decision, lahu al-hukmu. And he has decided, وَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخر. Because if you invoke others besides Allah, you will be making aliha besides Allah. When la ilaha illallah, everyone dies except Allah, and the decision is his. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Look at this warning here, a threat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going to go back to him, and you'll have to answer for what you do in this life. Subhanallah. Some ayat, wallah, I'll be looking at them and say, I can't finish this ayah in one khutbah even. When I was in a masjid, I was given khutbah for, you know, months. Alhamdulillah ta'ala, always given khutbah at that masjid. We spoke about the pillars of Islam and the pillars, the pillars of Iman first and the pillars of Islam. We spoke about the hadith when Jibreel alayhi salam came to our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him, akhbirni an al-Iman, akhbirni an al-Islam, akhbirni an al-Ihsan. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam combined in one hadith the pillars of Iman and the pillars of Islam and the excellence in doing each and every one of these pillars of Iman and Islam, Ihsan. Subhanallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained this magnificently. Now, that's a hadith, one hadith. I told people, I can't possibly give this hadith in one khutbah. Wallah, it took me months of explaining every aspect of that hadith, and I couldn't finish everything because the people said, okay, we got it. We need another topic. This is one of the ayat. All of the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are magnificent. Every letter in the Quran came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every letter that came to our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is a Quran. We have it today. We'll always have it. Allah kept it for us. The sunnah that explains the Quran is still intact. We have it today. Just reach out to it. Reach out, knowledge, you know. Take a book and read the book of Allah. Read the book of ahadith. Read Riyad al-Salihin, full of ayat and ahadith. May Allah give Jannah to Imam al-Nawawi. That book is, wallah, one of the most beautiful books of Islam. Read about it. Then you will know what's for you and what might be against you. And how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Three steps. Don't listen to people who are wasting your time and giving you all kinds of things, you know, especially the person who nowadays, he throws something. Yeah, the hadith, this hadith has that, you know, what? Okay, we know what. So what's your problem with the hadith? Another lecture, that hadith, this ayah. That ayah, this hadith, forget about it. Three steps. If somebody comes and says to you, invoking others besides Allah is not shirk, if somebody does it out of ignorance, tell them, no. Invoking is an act. And the person who does it is a person. Don't mix them together. Because shirk always remains shirk, it doesn't change. But worshiping others besides Allah, you know, cannot be say, you know, explained away by saying it is bid'ah. So we have to add these things that, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the knowledge, gave us the explanation. So somebody says, those who invoke Allah out of jahl, ignorance, it's not shirk in their case. Tell them, I don't care for what you say. Always shirk. Now, three-step verification. Al-du'a'u huwa al-ibada. Please don't tell me I need to explain it in English again. Al-du'a'u huwa al-ibada. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa'budu allaha wa la tushriku bihi shay'a. So al-du'a'u huwa al-ibada. Al-ibada here. وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. If somebody, you know, worship others besides Allah, and we said already that worship is dua, so anyone who makes dua to other than Allah is committing shirk, and this is a part of Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. وَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرٌ. They can aliha besides Allah by doing what? The dua. And the dua is an ibadah. Don't worship others with Allah. Do not invoke others with Allah. Do not take others as aliha besides Allah. وَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَهُ لَهُ الْحُكْمُ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. الدعاء هو العبادة. Imam Ahmad, Abu Dawood, Al-Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Al-Hakim collected this hadith. And Imams Al-Hakim, Al-Dhahabi, Al-Albani stated it is sahih, authentic. Ayah number 36 in Surah An-Nisa, which is Surah number 4. وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Worship Allah and associate nothing and no one with Him in the worship. And Ayah number 88 in Surah Al-Qasas, which is Surah number 28. وَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَهُ لَهُ الْحُكْمُ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Three steps started with الدعاء, عبادة, shirk if someone does it for other than Allah. All this is a type and a part of Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us knowledge in the religion and make us among the righteous. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all kinds of rewards for the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and for the As-Salaf al-Salih and the scholars of Islam, including the four Imams who preserved for us this precious knowledge. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.